Hi, Brian here for Directus. In this video, we're gonna dive even deeper down the rabbit hole and show you how to recreate some of the most common use cases for the powerful roles and permission feature inside Directus. If you're not already familiar with the basics of how roles and permissions work, I'd recommend checking out our overview video first and then coming back. We're gonna cover four use cases. The first is the public role. What data is available to the general public from your API? The second is gonna be how to create a website user so that your server can communicate with Directus. Number three is gonna be restricting access to data based on certain types of users. And number four is a doozy, how to create tenancy inside Directus. With that, let's dive into our first use case, setting up the public role. The public role controls what API data is available without authentication. So anybody in the public, any random person, can access this data. And for that reason, you want to be pretty strict about what you allow. So in this case, we're only going to allow the articles collection inside our instance to be available to the public. So I'll just go in and click all access under the read permission, and I'm going to test this out by opening up another tab, dropping my URL in there, and adding items/articles. Now I can also see that we've got all of our articles here, but maybe I don't want to show the draft articles to our users. So I'm going to go in and under the read permission, I'm going to give this a custom permission. In the items permissions section, I'm going to add a filter for the status. So I only want to show articles where the status is equal to published. I'll save that and then test this out one more time. As you can see, now we're only getting articles that are published. But I could also take this one step further and say I don't want to show the status, or maybe I don't want to show the ID field or some other sensitive data. I'll go back to our permissions and go to the field permission section. And here is where I can control what fields the public role can actually view. So we've set the items that they can view. Now we're going to set the fields that they have access to. I'll just refresh the page and you could see those hidden fields no longer display in the API response. So that's a really simple use case for setting up a public role. You may have other collections that you want to enable, but I would highly advise you against giving create, update, or delete access to the public role. Be very careful. Let's cover our next use case, creating a website user. Maybe you have a contact form or a demo request form on your website that you want to push that data inside your Directus instance whenever the user submits it. Maybe to a inbox collection or some other collection that you've got. We don't want anybody in the general public to be able to submit this data. It's a good way to open yourself up for attack. So instead, we're going to create a new role for this. So we'll just click the create role button and give this a name, maybe website. I will disable app access for this particular role, and then I'll go in and set the permissions that I want our website front end to be able to access. In this case, I'm just going to enable the create access for the inbox collection. So now we've created the user role, we need to actually create our website user. So I'll hop over to the users directory and create a new user for the website role. I'm not going to fill out email or password. I'm going to hop right down to the token section and generate a new static access token. Make sure you copy this and keep it in a safe place because you won't be able to see it again. And typically this is going to go into your ENV file. And if you're using the Directus SDK, your setup might look something like this, where you've got the static token that you're passing to the auth object when creating a new instance of the SDK. And that's it. Now you have direct server-to-server communication with your Directus API. All right, let's jump into our next use case, which is restricting data access based on the type of user or the user role. Maybe I have several employees that I want to assign tasks to, but I don't want them to see anyone else's tasks. So I can jump into our staff role in this case. I'll scroll down to the tasks collection and let's update some permissions. I still want these users to be able to create tasks for themselves, so I'm going to give all access to the create operation. And on the other operations, I'm going to use custom permissions. So I'll open up the read operation and click use custom. And here under item permissions, we're going to create a rule using a dynamic variable. So I'm going to go to the assign to field and I am going to key in $current_user.id. Now they'll only be able to see tasks that they've been assigned to. But there's a problem because what happens if they create a task? I still want them to be able to see that. I could solve that by using the or filter group and creating another rule for the user created field. So I'll do the same variable, current_user.id, and I'll put those in the or group. And now this specific user will only see tasks that they've been assigned to or tasks that they've created. And don't forget to update the field permissions to let this user see all the fields with the tasks. Now we'll jump into the update operation and apply the same rules. So under item permission, I'll set the exact same thing up. And now that that's done, I'm gonna hop into field permissions and make sure I update the fields that they can update. Simple enough. All right, so we'll save this operation. And for the delete permissions, I'm not going to let them delete tasks, so I'm just gonna leave that blank. But now I can log in as this specific user and test it out. So as you can see, this user only has two tasks out of hundreds that are in that collection that show up when they log in. And if I switch back and forth, you can easily see the difference. Now we'll switch back and I will go ahead and create a task just to check that as well. I'll add some sample test data here and save it just to make sure this is working. But as you can see, everything checks out okay. And that's it for restricting user data based on a role. All right, the last use case is creating tenancy. So how do we set up multi-tenants in a single Directus instance? I'm starting with a blank slate here. We're gonna create a new collection for our tenants. You could call this tenants. I really like accounts as the terminology. I'll use the generated UUID field type, and I'm just going to add some optional system fields here. For this accounts collection, I'm going to give it a name, make that required, so they have to fill that out. And I'm also going to add a slug just to give another type of identifier. Maybe I want to expose that on the front end. And I will make sure that is a unique value. And I'm gonna hop over to the interface tab and make sure I check the slugify box to make sure this is input correctly. So that's it for our tenant collection. The next collection that we're going to create is going to be the task collection. We'll just stick with the same theme. We'll use the generated UUID field again and add some optional system fields. The most important part about this task collection is creating a many-to-one relation to that tenant collection, which is called accounts. So I'll do a key for called account, and the related collection is going to be accounts. And for the display template, I'll simply do the name. I'll save this. And let's go in and add some task data, like a title, and we'll keep this really simple. Maybe just a toggle for completed. And save. All right, so the last step of this process is to go into our systems collection to Directus users, and we're going to add that many to one relation for accounts to the user as well. So each user belongs to an account. We'll choose the accounts as the related collection and set the name as the display template. Perfect. So now we've got our data model set up. We're going to hop into the roles and set up a new role for these front-end users. If you are doing a SaaS app, you may want to turn off app access, but I'm gonna leave this on just to showcase this functionality to you guys. I'll hit save, and now we'll go in and start editing our permissions. All right, so first we're gonna work on the accounts collection. I'll go to the read operation, and under the items permissions, I'm going to use the ID equals the dynamic variable, current underscore user, and the key that we're gonna pick up this time is account, because we just created that account field on the Directus user collection. So I'll do the same for updates. I'll go in and the account ID equals current user dot account, and that will restrict any user from viewing, editing, or updating any account that they do not own. All right, so now that we're done with accounts, let's move on to tasks. I'm gonna use a quick little shortcut here and give all permissions and then dial that back. That allows me to save a few steps. So we'll go into the create operation, and I'm gonna leave all these field permissions available. But when it comes to the field presets, I want to pre-populate that user account. So I'm just gonna add some JSON here, and I'm gonna use that dynamic user variable to populate that data for a new task. Now, I will open up the read operation, and under item permissions, we're gonna go in and add some rules here. So I'm looking for the account field, and the rule is gonna be equals to $current_user.account. So that will prevent any user from seeing tasks that are not in their account. We'll do that for the update operation as well as the delete operation. Perfect. All right, so now we've got accounts and tasks set up. Let's go in and create an account and test this out. So we'll give it a name, give it a slug test tenant. Let's save this specific account. And then we can go in and create a couple sample users. So we'll do a test tenant user, give them a login and a password. Hey, that's great. We will make sure we select the account that they are a part of, save this user, and then we can log in to test out our work. And voila, now we have set up Tenancy inside our Directus instance, and this is gonna work with the API as well as the app. So you could use this for a SaaS use case, or if you have multiple clients that you want to serve inside one Directus instance, this is one way that you can achieve that. So that's it for some of the most common use cases for Directus roles and permissions. If you have other use cases that you'd like us to cover, hop into our Directus community Discord server, check us out on Twitter, or just contact us through the website. And make sure you subscribe to the YouTube channel so you can get notified when our next video drops.